and very strong. And the rest of it is kind of in the middle somewhere. I mean, I think the average for this game, because the stats aren't the same, like, it's not 10 is plus 0, it's, I think, 8 to 14 is plus... No, 8 to... maybe 9 to 13 for certain ones. But it's not...
9 and 12 are at least zeros.
Yeah. So your 15 is actually not enough to make it out of the other thing. Thank you, Nor, for making a marking. Charisma definitely is enough to get a buff to a couple of things. Yeah, your magical defense, your henchman number goes up. If you were playing a caster that uses charisma, you get some bonus spells. Or no, that's wisdom. Why is it freaking charisma and wisdom's block is the same? Goddamn. So 16. So yeah, number of max henchmen's fairly high. They're very loyal, and you're really good at talking to people. You got a plus 5 on 2d6, I believe. No, that can't be right on d20. But still, plus 5 is pretty nice for this game. And Nor is nearly bog standard, except for the 5. I'm almost certainly you're above my limit with a 15, 16. 15, 27, 37, 46. Yeah, 52, and then, you know, you're well above my 55 limit. Theo rolled one number off for 55 when we rolled the first time, and Theo was very bad, except for... What was it? You had like one really good stat and everything else was utter garbage.
Yeah, I don't remember.
Yeah, it was something like charisma or something. Leo, you have the book, so you can actually look down and check the races. But the races are, well, humans are the base. Your stats don't move if you're human, but you can play any class that you want because you don't have the, restrictions of being a different race. Dwarves, elves, gnomes, half-elves, halflings, and then, of course, I just said humans. Humans are normal. Let's see for Nor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is definitely above 50, so... Frickin' heck, Nor, though. That constitution is not going to be good.
There's four classes, right?
Yep. There's four main classes. There is the fighter, the mage, the cleric, and the thief. But there is some in-between, too. But I'm like, yeah, good luck being a paladin or a ranger, though, because their stat requirements are very high. Bards, I think, are actually... No, bards aren't even in your ballpark if you need to be dexterous.
I'm a little dexterous.
You also need to be intelligent.
Yeah,
I'm not intelligent.
Let's see for Nor.
Oh, look,
Nor's already put his things in.
I can't do ranger.
Yeah. By the way, basically everyone can do fighter. If you can't do fighter, it's very bad. You have rolled very, very poorly. Mage is similar. Cleric, I think, is... Yeah, all you need for the base classes is 9 in whatever their main
faction is. I can't do cleric because I'm wisdom minus 1. I could do mage.
Don't worry, you already have a cleric. You have a Theo. Who's playing a gnomish priest?
I could be a muscle mage.
Yeah.
I can't be a bard because that's too smart. I can't be a druid because that's too wisdom.
So are you just being human for this case?
I haven't decided yet. I don't even know what class I want to be. I don't even know what race to be. Okay, if I want to be a mage, what can I not be? Race.
You can't be a dwarf. Dwarves can't be mages. I believe it's actually only elf. Yeah, human, elf, and half elf.
Human, elf, and half elf.
Yep. And that's just base mage, because I think all of the wizard specializations are out of your reach. Actually, maybe the enchanter. The enchanter needs 16 in charisma, and you got that.
Oh, hex, yeah.
So you could go with enchanter.
Okay, so let's say...
Alright. Nor, you don't have the book, so...
I do.
You have your stats. Oh, you do have the book now?
Any suggestions for class?
I mean, you could play a mage. Your stat line would work for that. I mean, you could play a wizard. It's not heavily suggested because of your minus one to your hit points.
What's the difference between mage and wizard?
They're basically the same. Wizard is like kind of the overarching thing, and mage is like one of the specific classes. Because there's four archetypes, and then there's classes inside of those archetypes. So wizard is the basic idea for all of the magic users. I think they used to be called magic users rather than wizard. But the main one is mage. Specialists, unfortunately, are not possible for Nor because of his stat line. Same for illusionists. Because illusionists need insane dexterity.
I'll be a mage.
Yep. Honestly, Nor, actually, your stats for any of the base classes fit. You can literally play any of the base classes. I would not heavily suggest fighter because of your minus one to hit points.
Yeah,
like, if you get smacked, it's gonna hurt. And you're not quick enough to be, like, really good at getting out of the way. So, yeah, I would suggest either mage or thief would be a good option. You could probably pull off priest, too, because you get some bonus spells.
Give me so much options.
Yep. But the thing is, your stat line is, like, so normal that, like, you got about average in everything. So you can play anything. It's just they're kind of eh.
The only high thing I have is intelligence and wisdom.
Yep. Yeah, the only thing carrying you down is the con.
Where's the enchanter?
The enchanter is in the specialist wizards. So I believe... I don't know if they have a different... they don't have like a different part of it. It's just part of wizard. You just get different things.
Let me see.
Yep.
Okay, so we'll probably do that.
All right. So go ahead and write enchanter down.
Oh, human mage.
A human mage?
Yeah.
All right. So you are level one human mage.
That will be a
human. And yeah, Leo, what are you being for race?
Does it matter? Oops.
I mean, elves are going to shift your stat around.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I mean, it's gonna move one stat down and one stat up. That's the difference. I believe your dex increases by one if you're an elf. Yeah, your dex goes up by one and your con goes down by one. And you can, like, see in the dark and whatnot, which is kind of neat.
Sure, let's do that. Let's go full elf.
Oh, right. Oh, yeah, you're also nearly immune to sleep spells and charm spells. Which is kind of nice for you. Because another enchanter looks at you and goes, aha! And you go, I'm an elf, frick you! Oh, this is in addition to the normal? Wow, that's mean. As a minor thing for charm spells, apparently, against elves, first you have to beat their, like, they have to fail their save, and you have to beat a 90% chance of failure for your spell. That's mean. Okay. So, would you like to be an elf or a human? You are an elf. So, have you moved your stats around?
No, I have not.
Alright, so your dex goes up by 1 to 13, and your con goes down by 1 to 9. Which, thankfully, doesn't mean anything other than your system shock and survival, or red survival, which, honestly, neither of these will probably come into account. You know, hopefully. All right, I forgot. Elves just have straight up improvision. All right. Have you found the elvish thing in like the book, Leo? Like the elven race?
He's dead.
Oh no!
Hello.
We can hear you now.
Excellent.
All right. So you have Theo and a pair of mages. Oh, this is going to be so great.
Theo, who
is not a very good front line.
Yeah, who grievously reduced all his physical stats in order to be able to.
Oh, this is gonna go so great.
Have a qualifying score to be a cleric.
Yep. Yeah, you have old man Theo. Yeah, and it's not the slightly old man. It's the you're basically very close to your deathbed old man. He's got 60 years, I believe, before he dies. Full age.
Employing a bow of any sort other than a crossbow.
I have a what is that, a something or around a 20% chance of just one-shotting myself with my own attack if I like threw a javelin at myself.
I mean, to be fair, that's almost everyone. Most likely both of your mages are going to have the exact same issue. Speaking of hit points, do you guys want to do that quick before we move on to class? Since you've already move on to the rest. All right. Okay. So, let's find out. How many hit points do mages get?
A ton.
Right. Yeah, it is so many. You have a 1d4. Oh, right. This is the time where mages are not very good. At least hit point wise. So, whoever wants to roll for hit points, go ahead and roll that d4. With a minus one. Yep.
Can I just die in character creation?
No, you have minimum one hit point, so.
I just roll one and automatically die.
It's not traveler, no. Fail the survival check.
Oh.
Hey, you have the most hit points you can have.
Oh, we have to roll for hit points?
Oh, yeah.
Alrighty, what do we roll for hit points?
You're a mage, so a d4.
Wow.
So how many hit points do you have again?
Five. Isn't it three?
Oh, you have five. I forgot. You rolled actually pretty well.
Ha!
Oh, this is going to be awful.
Raise kit, AC, HP.
Simple, just out DPS the enemy before they have a chance.
I mean, that's literally what you guys are going to have to do. I mean, it's a pretty good thing that at least one of you is, like, very, very sharp, right?
I think. 17 intelligence.
No, the answer is no, you're not. Neither of you are particularly sharp. Let me find out.
You know,
does having a high wisdom give you additional bonus spells when you're a... No, is the answer.
I have 12.
Yay. I mean, you're smart enough. I mean, you can cast a higher level spell than Leo can, if you guys survive long enough to do that. Alright. So... mages have their hit points. I'm trying to think what else we need to do for that.
So when it says clerical spell failure percent chance, is that just like a flat chance that your spell will fail when you cast it?
I'm gonna bet probably. I'll go take a peek. While I'm doing that though. You guys should go ahead and pick alignment. And then move on to proficiencies. Let's find out. Magic. Actually, it's probably an armor, I would bet. Does it bother mentioning anything about the spell failure chance? Or is it only in the box?
It's wisdom related. It's...
Oh, right, yeah.
Let's see, wisdom. Measure the bonus spell's chances. Percent chance that any particular spell fails when cast. Priests with low charisma scores.
So the answer is yes. Yeah. Every time you cast a spell, if your wisdom is not 13 or higher, the spell could just say frick you and not go off. Thankfully, it's pretty low.
Oh, hey, I'm on a 13 or higher.
Relatively low for you, Theo. You have a 1 in 5 chance of your blessed spell just going, no, I'm good. I don't feel like working. I mean, at least the mages don't have that chance, unless you're wearing armor.
Almost all my problems would have been solved by just picking human.
Yeah. All right, so what's the next step? What do we need to do next?
So, well, you guys have picked alignments, so we need to do proficiencies. Alignments are exactly the same as they are in 5e.
No, let's just be, we're going to be lawfully evil. There we go.
I mean, I'll hold you to it. Most likely that will get you killed even faster than you would otherwise.
But... What? No, it won't. Lawful evil, that means I'm like, you know, like evil for pay.
Yep. Like, you're paying. These characters believe in using society and its laws to benefit themselves. So yeah, you won't immediately stab people.
No, I'm going to be like, hey, listen, if you pay me, I will enchant something that will curse somebody.
You're just an arsehole, is the main thing, yes. All right, so proficiency slots. Let me remember what your guys' intelligence is, because that is the thing that affects proficiencies. So, Nora has an additional 3, and I believe Leo has fewer than that. Yes, by 1. So, for mages, since you're both wizards, you guys have 1 weapon proficiency, and Nor has 7 non-weapon proficiencies, including languages, and Leo has 6. So if you scroll to the very bottom of this character sheet, you can just ignore the rogue skills. You guys don't need them, because you aren't rogues. So why do you need to... Yep, so you guys each have 1 weapon proficiency, and then a whole bunch of other stuff. By the way, you automatically know common. I'll just write that in because you guys both know it automatically.
How many languages did you say?
The thing is, it's not all languages. It's just all non-weapon proficiencies. So if you really wanted to, you could just sync all of those into languages, but you basically have no skills. So
page 70.
I mean, for you, actually, that's not so bad because you're actually good at talking to people. I'm trying to remember. Theo, do you remember if this languages are in the skills chapter?
No,
I don't think they are. Yeah, no, it's part of the race. I think humans can just learn all of them pretty much. They don't really care.
I wish it would just tell me weapons. It just says weapon. It talks about weapon proficiencies, but it doesn't tell me
what it's weapon proficiencies. There is a list of weapon proficiencies.
Shortbow, longbow, composite bow, heavy and light crossbow, dagger, knife, glaive, halberd,
Bardiche, yeah. Vlug. Or Volg. I don't remember if that's how you would know that. Yeah. Gusarm, glaive, Gusarme.
Yeah.
I mean, that's probably good for you, seeing as you're traveling.
Footman's
Why not a longbow?
Horseman's mace.
Oh, I don't know, because I thought it was going to be very interesting.
Flare. Hammer. Bub. Military force. What?
Aren't you... Your dex is actually pretty decent, isn't it? Yeah, you have 13. You're not going to shoot yourself in the foot.
Shoot Theo in the foot.
Scimitar. Oh, all right,
that would be pretty hard, because he's significantly shorter than you are.
Sword. They have 6 of these.
Yep.
Spanish reading or writing in French and German, etc.
Yeah, no, it's not that.
That's what it says.
The languages you can learn as an elf are... Come on, I know it's here thing. You can't hide them. You can learn...
The stand is to hide it.
Yeah. An elf can choose from common, elf, gnome, halfling, goblin, hobgoblin, orc, and gnoll.
Let's learn elf.
Yeah, you probably want to learn at least elf.
Learn gnoll, just because it sounds funny.
Staff sling?
That's 2 proficiencies, and I have 4 left.
Right? It's 1 weapon, by the way, Nor. So do you want to use a staff or do you want to use a sling?
First aid question mark.
For like the weapon proficiencies. They're one weapon. I'm guessing there's supposed to be a freaking comma there.
Well, they have sling and staff sling.
Why the heck do they have staff sling? I've never heard of a weapon called a staff sling.
So
I want to guess staff sling on the end, like a spindle.
Perfect.
I'm going to bet that weapon doesn't actually exist, and the thing is just missing a comma, and it's bad.
Well, okay, then they put
yeah. a sling
twice.
Yep.
This is sling, staff. Oh yeah, I forgot sling.
Because I'm seeing sling. Oh no, they do. Staff sling. I have no idea what this is. What the hell is a staff sling? I'm going to look it up, see if they have it. Do they have a description for it? Because I've never ever heard of a weapon called a staff sling. That is very interesting and strange. They don't have a description of it. What the goddamn hell is a staff sling? Yeah, that's a. Are they literally? Is it just a sling? Yeah, it's just a sling on a big stick, is what it is.
Yeah.
That's hilarious. So it's a mini catapult, or not catapult, a mini trebuchet, a handheld one.
A superior weapon, if you ask me.
I mean, it works. Yes, that is definitely a weapon. How much damage does it do? It doesn't actually have. Oh, it's because it's based on the sling stone or sling bullets. It's based on the stuff you put inside of it, because the weapon itself doesn't deal any damage, because it's just a big stick. So yeah, that is a legit thing. It's a weird thing I've never heard of, but it is definitely a thing.
That is why I grabbed it. I looked for yeah. Because I am Wizard Man.
Yeah.
And I saw a sling, and I'm like, oh, that's a nice bonus. I probably shouldn't be up, you know, close to the enemies.
It's probably a good idea, since, yeah, one enemy's light slap will kill you.
Hold on, I didn't see there was a wizard one. Gem cutting, that's cool. Astrology, oh no, wait.
Yep. So you guys pick off the wizard list and the general list for the non-weapon proficiency groups. So ancient history, astrology, engineering, gem cutting, etc., etc. By the way, you should probably take reading writing, because otherwise it's assumed that you don't know how.
What?
Yep. Scam looks at you guys, not you're dumb.
Alright.
So is that non-weapon?
Two separate things?
The staff sling is a weapon, yeah.
No, I'm talking about reedy righty.
No, it's not a weapon. It would be a non-weapon proficiency.
Are those two separate things?
No, it's the same skill.
I thought it was going to be like two different things. Like you either learn how to read or you know how to write, you dumb bitch.
Yep. Character can read and write a modern language he can speak, provided there is someone available to teach the character. Yay! Yeah, so you can read and write what you can speak, because otherwise you can only talk.
You know what? Fuck Noel. You know what? Noel is just boring. That's
So, Noor, have you found the proficiencies thing? The non-weapon proficiencies? Perfect. This is a big, long list.
No.
Page 76. Yeah, they just don't have specialized there. So yeah, you guys pick off the wizard or the general. Yay. What kind of cobbling on there? Nice singing. There's talking to people ones. There's etiquette, I suppose.
Okay. Wow, Theo, as a priest, can learn a musical instrument.
Yeah.
Navigation. Ooh. That might be better than cooking.
So how many points do I have right now?
I didn't learn it.
Like after reading writing, you should have 6 additional.
Damn, he's so smart.
Yeah, wizards have four non-weapon proficiencies, and then because of your intelligence, you add to them. And because you have 12 intelligence, you gain 3, and Leo gets 2. Leo is 9.
All right, I'm done. I've picked my things. I'm locked in.
Oh, right. Now you need monies. Have you found that, the listener? On 76.
Yeah.
Good. Yay.
Wait, I saw first aid, but I don't see it on the table. Is it under someone specific? There's first aid, somebody something anybody can do.
Where is first aid?
Well, it was one of the things that said, if I scrolled back up where it says non-weapon proficiencies, it was like, just like a player's character is defined as this, this, and this. Things that are basic. And it just said, it said first aid is one of them. So I was like, okay.
Hmm. I think it's called healing in this.
On page 73, it says first aid.
Let me see. So you already found issues. Oh, yeah. For non-weapon proficiencies, yeah. Yeah, this is the... It's slightly different. Because the way that they have it set up is that there's three different methods of using non-weapon proficiencies. There is the you know what you know, the secondary skills, which is just kind of, you know, like a general setup for stuff.
I see.
And then there's the one we're using, which is the more like the skill system for 3.5 or 5e. Okay, which I don't know why there isn't healing or first aid.
Is brewing for potions or for like brewing like alcohol?
I would bet brewing, as in like brewing alcohol, but let's find out because they've explained all of them.
Oh,
brewing. Yep, brewing beers and strong drink.
Okay, I don't want that.
So yes, it is straight up just alcohol. It's not potion making.
You were asking.
Oh, there it is. Yeah, there is healing, but it's priest specific, apparently.
Fuck you, Theo.
That's right. I didn't take it either.
Fuck you, Theo.
I have 9 wisdom. What do you want from me?
So you barely squeaked by.
Yep. What skills did you take, Theo?
I took random ones.
Yep. Endurance, spellcraft, armor, navigation, reading, writing, seamanship, swimming, ancient history. So
I'm gonna take etiquette because it's the only one that I can see that has charisma as a.
Yep.
Okay.
I mean, yeah, I'm pretty sure you can just try and convince people because I don't think there's like a charm specific skill. At least I'm not seeing one.
But
charm or lying or whatever. There's disguise, but that's.
Oh wait, singing sounds... is charisma. But oh wait.
Yep.
Singing.
So, I would guess that most of the time you're just going to be rolling straight charisma, which is actually good for you because you need to roll under the number, so you need to beat a 16. Oh no.
Gaming is charisma based. Unfortunately, only warriors know how to game.
Yep, they're the only ones.
Theo, I've decided
what?
That your character is old. Okay. He shall see the stars after grabbed astrology and engineering.
Hell yeah.
So what, you have 7, 2 for engineering, 2 for astrology. Ancient history is 1. Or you don't have ancient history, you have languages.
Language.
Freaking heck, how the hell did I misread that? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep, cool. By the way, I think you're supposed to pick a specific reading, writing, and specific language. Let's go find out which specific languages exist. Do they not have it? Am I just going to have to freaking guess?
No, it just means know all ancient language.
I mean, it gives you a shot at knowing all of them, I think, but... Freaking heck. Oh, it's probably under language. That's why I'm not seeing it in A's. I went way too far. And once you're done with this, by the way, go to the starting money, which is at the very, very beginning of the money and equipment, which is the next chapter. Languages would be under L, which I can't find because I freaking blew past it.
Oh, when I select ancient history, I meant to choose something specific.
Oh, you are?
Yeah, so I'm going to choose boats.
Well, there's language modern. Where the hell is language ancient history? There it is. Characters master, difficult, or obscure tongue, now primarily found in the writings of pedantic sages and sorcerers. The main use of language is to read tomes of ancient secrets written by long-dead mystics. To read, write, or speak the language of his choice. I'm guessing you want to read and write it, because speaking an ancient language seems kind of not useful.
Yes, the language of Star.
Let me see if I can't find the language. Thing? Let's comprehend languages.
Okay, 50 gold.
Yay. You'll definitely be able to buy a nice staff, because the staff is worth 2 silver.
Hell yeah.
Where the heck is... I know there is just a list of languages. Why can't I find it? 22, 27, and 82. Okay.
Wait, can I just buy a house?
I mean, if you have the money. I don't think you want to, because you won't be in your house.
Maybe you want to just retire. Couple on my head.
What are we doing now?
Now you're doing the monies.
Oh, okay.
Which should be the same thing as Nor, just a d4 plus 1 times 10, is it? Or
did you already do it, Leo?
Plus 1 times...
No, that was his hit points, I believe.
Okay.
Times 10.
Yep. What the hell? Leo.
What?
They despise you apparently at this point.
I'm so much to my knees.
Yep. I mean, at least you and Nora can share. Unfortunately, no. Theo can't, because Theo is a priest, and the priests are like, no.
What? What does that mean?
They follow their gods. They can't just be given money to any sort of freaking rando that they meet.
Charity? Hello?
That's for the temple to do. Yeah. Regardless, Theo, you ended up with like literally the exact amount of money that you can still just keep. So. Because I think it's 2 to 3, yeah, 2 to 3 gold for like your travel expenses, basically. Yeah, paladins, by the way, in this, you know, you basically can't keep anything.
Oh, I actually, because I switched from trident to knife, I actually had a lot more, so should I be spending some of that?
I mean, if you want to, yeah.
I ended up with 16 gold.
Knowing the regional language. I need more than just the regional language, though, game. Tell me what the languages are. I need them. Number of languages. That's 22. Let's go check out 82, because that's got to be where the actual languages are. Freaking heck, Theo. We did not find a good book.
Yeah, no.
This one seems to have some issues.
It may be that this was intended for, like, hey, here's the player's handbook, and then what are the languages? Oh, well, that depends on if you're in Faerun or Dragon, whatever.
Dragonlance, yeah.
Well, so what are we doing now?
I'm trying to think. Ancient languages. You know what? For the sake of freaking argument, because I have no idea what languages Dragonlance would have. Let me see. Dragonlance languages, they probably have that. Languages, if I can actually spell it. Now we need to do spells.
Uh-oh.
I mean, you guys get more than Theo does, so it's good for you.
Yeah.
How many All more right. do they get? I got one.
I don't know. I think it's based on your. It's based on mage. Let's find out. How many spells do wizards get? The answer is no more. They get one.
Wow, welcome to my world.
Why?
What did I miss?
Did you buy money stuff?
No, I didn't. Big list.
Well, you guys need a weapon and then foods and clothing and whatever else you need.
What page is that on? Let's see. Money and equipments, 89.
Yep. Money and equipments. Yep.
Let's see.
Page 90. I mean, if you had a high enough wisdom for a priest, you can get some bonus spells, but apparently they're the only ones who get them.
Bonus spells.
Yeah, that's why I was checking if you have a high enough wisdom, if the bonus spells are for anyone else, but no, it literally is only priests who get it.
Yeah.
If you're a good priest, you actually get already a second level. I mean, it's not like you get that many more, you get an additional spell.
Yeah.
Yay! Oh no, priest with 15 gets... Oh, maybe you get one of each spell that you go up. Ooh.
Branded armor, where's...
Okay, I shall buy a pigeon.
Yeah, by the way, armor doesn't have proficiencies, so...
Wait, yep. I can't even buy a longbow.
And you should go switch out to the other thing, or ask if you could borrow some from your other wizard.
This is so expensive, it's 75 gold!
Jeez, Fuck so no, up, not even your other wizard will give you enough money.
Okay, so we're gonna buy a
cartwheel.
A cartwheel? Why do you want a cartwheel?
I don't know, I was thinking of, like, slowly piecing together a cart. I can afford, like...
Just build a cart out of the pieces.
Alright, so I have a dagger.
I have engineering.
And what else do we want to buy? And then I'll use a food stuff.
Freaking heck, yeah, you rolled so poorly that you can't even buy a short bow.
No. Let's buy lots of bread. So is it just a single piece of bread?
I guess...
Let's buy five, but no, how much bread is it? So it's two to make one silver.
Is it the daily food and lodgings thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, so most likely it's a daily's food worth of bread.
So if we just, okay, so eight of this, five silver pieces. And
bread is dirt cheap, yeah, five copper.
And then we get five.
I mean, it should be, it's freaking bread.
We have five bread. I'm sure that'll last us enough time.
Mm-hmm.
I want to buy...
Ooh, they sell ale per gallon, huh?
I'm going to use one of these silvers, and I'm going to get a cat. Cat. Perfect. Eggs! Wait, hold on. Per 100?
Yeah.
Oh my god, we're just going to buy a bunch of fucking eggs. Oh wait, dry
rations. Yeah, that's a household provisioning.
Yeah, but I can just buy eggs.
Why do you just want piles of eggs?
Because you can eat those, Mitchell. You can eat eggs.
Alright, but if you don't... Make sure you buy the cooking utensils or you're gonna get fucked.
Wait, I have to also... Oh my god, I have to cook shit. Did I even take cooking again or did I take that off?
I don't know.
Oh, I took cooking. Excellent. Alright, where are the cooking utensils, Theo?
I don't know.
Tack and harness, miscellaneous equipment.
Yeah, it's probably miscellaneous, I would assume.
Probably. Oh, God. It's like a dagger. God damn it.
I mean, it's better than nothing because you can't run around and punch things.
Thieves pick. There's no
Do they just not have any cooking gear?
There's such thing as cooking gear, Theo. You lied to me. There's no such thing, Theo. You fucking piece of shit.
There's an iron pot.
I think those were shit.
I mean, it's pot. That's iron that you can put things in. Good enough.
You don't need an iron pot. That's not necessary. I'm not cooking rice or some shit or making a soup.
I imagine you're allowed to, like, modify it into an iron pan or something.
I see. All right, where is iron pot? It's A, B, C, D, E, F, G, top. Iron pot, 5, silver.
Yep.
How does this sound for clothing? Belt, boots, breeches, cap, cloak, gloves, tunic.
Yeah, it sounds like you've completely covered yourself in clothing, which is good. You're not wandering around nude.
Oh, shit. Clothing? Where's clothing? Cloth.
Don't worry, you can get yourself a toga. I'm sure that...
Comet is so expensive! It's sitting cold! You don't come with clothes.
No, you don't come with anything. Why do you think that you don't have any items to start with? This isn't the new games. We don't hold hands here.
All right,
start with one spell that you have to use over the course of the day.
All right, so I have
one.
But I need to buy eggs. I need my eggs. Oh wait, no. Okay. So I can use 9 silver.
Eight
of my 9 silver.
Yeah, eight silver.
All right, so I got 100 eggs, right? So eggs. I have 100 eggs. Hopefully this doesn't. And then my last 7 gold, I can use to buy common cloth.
Why not just buy a common robe? You're a wizard.
That's what I'm getting, right?
Yeah, that's what you should get. You're a wizard.
Like I said, just get a toga. Eight copper.
It's near the very bottom, right above tunic. It's basically a sackcloth toga.
Tunic.
Get that in some
the miscellaneous?
No, in the clothing.
There's a clothing section.
Yep. At the top left of the equipment on page 90. Yep.
Oh, I see. I was just about to fucking use set. Okay. I'm so glad we looked at this. A pin of what? Like just like a pin, like a safety pin?
Yeah. I don't know.
I mean, to be fair, Theo, you could buy things and then give them to your companions.
I mean, that's what I was thinking of.
I mean, it's not lending them gold, but you rolled significantly better than they did.
The thing is, I wanted to I had not actually bought clothing. I just bought a ox, and so
they do by the way have rations that you can get.
Where do you see those
in household provisioning ration standard?
Oh, okay.
21,
so you can just buy them by the week too, it looks like.
21
actually, that looks like it's the only way to buy them. I don't see rations anywhere else.
All right, I bought a gown.
So are you a lady wizard?
Right, I am a lady wizard.
A knife sheath is enough.
Are you getting a girdle?
Do I need a knife sheath, or can I just hold my knife at all?
You just walk around with it.
Alright, knife sheath is 3 copper. We can afford that.
I mean, you could probably stick it in your gown somewhere, but
in the bra.
Yeah. Well, then you need a girdle. Yeah.
A girdle? What? I don't come with a bra? You're gonna make me come with a bra?
Besides, you're an elf.
How much girdle? 3 gold pieces! Oh my god! Y'all are charging women out of the wazoo. See, I think I saved myself some money buying the gown, because now I don't have to buy... Because if I get the tunic, I would have to... Or the vest, not the vest, the toga, I'd have to get a sash. You know, you gotta belt it, because that way it gives it a little bit of a figure. But the gown, I feel like, just has a figure to it. You know what I mean? And then, I guess I can choose, so right? Shoes are kind of important. One gold piece, I guess.
Yeah. Shoes are expensive. You have to have someone make them for you.
Is there like cheap shoes?
I think those are called your feet.
No, we're gonna get
sandals.
We're gonna get soft.
Yeah,
boots.
Sandals would also be probably a lot cheaper.
No, we're getting soft boots. They're whole gold. Soft boots.
Soft Gucci boots.
Yeah. Based on your stats, I have a feeling you got kicked out for being too non-elfy.
There's 5 copper piece sandals.
God. Alright, so I have...
See, I'm walking around here in these Yeezys, having, riding boots.
Not riding boots, I'm just soft boots.
Oh, I know that. I'm just gonna look down at you, being like, yo.
You know what? You know what? I have 8 silver. I'm using my 8 silver for a fucking, good cloak. Get a good cloak on that. Good cloak.
Oh, yeah, one of those. Yeah, I
stopped. Yep. So the party so far, from what I've seen, just from buying and stat-wise, is an old man who's basically saved every goddamn copper that he's been able to scrounge over his entire lifetime working for a temple to finally get enough money to go out adventuring, like, on his, basically on his deathbed. A human mage who actually, like, got left home and actually, like, got gifted a little bit of money to actually be somewhat well-equipped for it. And then an elf got kicked out with what they had. It's very sad.
So I'm that rich kid who's like, oh, yeah, you know, I got everything. I'm a wizard now. I cast spells.
You left home when you were like, I can cast magic now.
All right, what else do I need? What is something that I need that isn't like... So I have food, I have 100 eggs, I have an iron pot thing.
You have a bag?
A bag, god damn it! Damn it, bitch.
Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, I also have a backpack.
Okay, where's that under?
Backpacks are 2 gold.
2 gold! Where's this under?
It's in miscellaneous, it's literally the first item. You can buy a sack. Just carry things around in that.
It's like a... Like... What kind of sack? Like, just like a...
Most likely a sock cloth. Just sackcloth sack.
Okay, let me get myself a large belt pouch.
Large belt pouch. Fanny pack is sounding pretty good. No, we'll
how are you going to carry 100 eggs in the fanny pack? if you smash them all, yeah, but the fanny pack won't be very useful after that.
Right, I'll take a backpack for my 100 eggs. I have 2 gold pieces. Backpack. Alright, what else do I possibly need that is necessary?
I mean, you have a weapon, you have piles of eggs, you have clothing.
Yeah.
Do you have rope or other useful things like that?
That's optional. I'm talking about like in things that I need. I can buy a swan.
You already have a cat!
Are you saying I can't have more than one animal compatriot?
No, but I'd be worried about the cat or the swan.
What do you mean? I don't think cats eat swans.
Yeah, but swans might eat cats. Oh, there are souls.
Oh yeah, let me get myself a lantern.
Oh, yeah, I have dark vision. Don't need it. Don't need a lantern.
You don't need dark vision. Or you don't need a lantern. You can see in the dark anyway.
Okay. Okay. We refund the cat, right? So we get the one silver back, right? The one silver back. Boom. And we refund the cat. Instead, we use, how much is this one? 5 silver pieces? All right. We turn our 2 gold pieces into 1, which gives us 11, which we then subtract 5 from, which is 7. Silver pieces, which means we have a swan now. Excellent.
Good.
Okay, I don't need a lantern. Rope sounds nice, though. Rope is probably useful.
Oh, God. Holy hell, ink got way more expensive in this edition.
God, it's one... You know what? Rope is an option. Rope is not needed. Mm. I could buy a quiver with no arrows.
Yeah, you guys are going to need to, like, spend for the mages. Like, the first thing that you guys buy is... Just writing ink and paper so you can actually like use your spell books. Hey, I guess that is one thing that you actually do have to start with is a spell book, because it's a requirement.
So we start off with a spell book, let me write that down. Spell book.
How much oil flash do I need?
I don't know. Do you want piles of lamp oil?
Well, I think it should be useful if I have a lamp. I probably shouldn't just grab one and be like, oh yes.
How long does the lamp stay lit? With,
I don't know.
Use of lamp oil. They probably have lamps, right? A pint of burning oil. Holy hell. Fire is very dangerous. Let's see. Do they have lamps? They do not. It's probably in light, I would bet. Let's see. Light. Oh, vision and light. It's literally its own chapter. Oh, they have visibility ranges? Oh.
This I makes have me a so bullseye happy. Lantern. Because, again, I can afford it.
Yep. Oh, they actually have, yeah, they have light sources, including the radius and the burning time. Holy heck, that's beautiful. Right.
Oh, let me get myself a dog.
You have a bullseye, you said?
Yeah.
So your bullseye has a radius of 60 feet. Of course, it can, yeah, it's not cast in a radius, it's in a cone-like beam. And per pint, it's 2 hours of light. So,
1 gold, 7 silver, and 7 copper left. I'm a dream come true. We can use one of these copper for some chalk. I'm sure this will be useful.
Right, I forgot. This, there is no such thing as cantrips in this edition, so.
What? What are we going to cast?
First levels and above.
Are we going to cast one spell?
Yep, so you better pick good ones.
Soap? Do we need soap?
How many spells do you start with as a wizard? Because this is, I believe, how many you cast per day, not the number that you know.
Well, thank you for reminding me about soap. Let me get like 5.
We only know...
Character understands the spell. No, that's not the right thing. Oh, you guys can actually determine what your spell book is like. It could be a single book, a set of books, a bundle of scrolls, or anything else, basically. You are breaking up hard, Leo. Why is it doing that thing?
Hello?
Nope, there it is. It cleared up.
I give him anything.
And then it immediately broke again the moment you started to talk. What the hell?
What?
You broke up. I couldn't understand anything that you were trying to say. How do we change where the server is again? Oh, here it is. Here, we'll move it again and see if that helps. All right. One more time, Leo. What were you attempting to say? Oh, no.
Yeah, you got 20 hours of lamp oil.
Alright.
Alright. How many spells does a mage start with? Let's find out.
Make myself also a tent.
Okay, so... Yeah, Leo's gonna have issues casting Invocation and Necromancy. Or Evocation and Necromancy. So not the Blasty Schools, or one of the Blasty Schools. Okay, so... First level Illusionist could have 2 spells, one being... Oh, that's kind of nice. So Specialists get an additional spell per level. So Leo actually has 2.
Hello?
Yep, we can hear you now.
Oh, can I give my swan a thing to carry?
I mean, it's a swan that you haven't trained. It's literally just a bird.
Wait, what do you mean? What do you mean it's not trained?
Of course it's not trained. Freaking trained animals cost... Do you see how much a freaking even war horse cost? Or not even a war horse, a riding horse costs?
Should I take animal... Should I have taken animal training?
I
believe riding. They do have that. They're riding. Do they have animal training? They have animal training and handling.
Okay, so what do I take?
I believe training would be what you're looking for.
Animal training. Okay, you know what? Fuck gem cutting. We're going to take animal.
Yeah, handling is more for pack animals and beasts of burden. I'm guessing training is more for your stuffs.
Alright, so animal training. So we can animal train instead of gem.
So you train swans.
Oh, I had to look specifically what I train?
Yep.
Swans.
Yep. That's what you're good at training.
I'm good at training swans specifically.
Well, you are able to train swans, I suppose.
Swans, I see. And then I come with a swan that is not trained that I will have to train at the time.
You know what? If you're spending the proficiency on animal training, I'll give you that it freaking already is trained. Because goddamn, I'm not going to be that mean.
Oh no! I need 3 gold pieces for a saddlebag.
You have rope, right? Just buy a sack, tie it around the swan.
I don't have rope. Rope is expensive. It's a whole gold piece.
Also, you know, riding, that's about 8 gold pieces.
Yep.
Wait, okay, a sack, wait, actually, so, okay, I use my last gold for rope, right? So we use it for how much?
15. And how much should we get of that, Mitchell?
For what?
Ink, just one thing for a vial, or how much would you...
Do you start with 0? That you want to buy, you can buy whatever you'd wish.
Well, I'm guessing we need writing ink for if we level up.
For level up, yeah, you're definitely gonna need ink. It's more for when you find spells, because this game is a lot more you do not gain very many spells over time.
Wait, can Leo and I just share spells?
I mean, if you have the writing ink so you can write into each other's spell books, yeah.
How much ink do we need to use for a spell?
How much ink is in the thing?
Small.
Like, I don't know, just writing ink per vial. So sold by vial.
Let's see.
There we go.
Trying to understand the instructions. You can enter the spell into a spell book. Drive rolls higher than the character's chance to learn the spell. Da, 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 da. I'm going to say it'll last you quite a while. I'm not going to say it needs something special or anything. Because that feels too mean. Let's see. How many freaking spells does a normal wizard start with? Wizards cannot wear armor for several reasons. Oh boy. It's not even allowing you to do that at all. And so wizard can use a dagger or a staff. Items that are traditionally useful in magical studies. Other weapons are allowed. Daggers, darts, knives, and slings.
Oh yeah, I'm wanting some flint and steel.
I'm guessing your freaking staff sling counts well enough. Because it's in there as both a staff and a sling individually. So I'm going to say it works for that too. And elves are elves. So. Wizard can use a magic weapon of any weapon allowed to his class, but cannot use magical armor. Da 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 da. Create new magic items. Oh, okay, you just have to reach level 9 and then you can make magic items. It's kind of nice. Intelligence is prime requisites.
Okay, I have 7 silver and 1 copper, but I'm ready. I don't need anything else. Unless I can give my swan a knife. But I don't think swans wield knives very well.
No, they don't.
They do not. All right, so what's next?
I'm trying to figure out how many spells you guys start with. That's the question. By the way, Leo, while you were breaking up, I figured out that because you're a specialist, you get a little buff. Well, it's a buff and a downside.
Okay.
You can cast an additional spell as long as the additional spell is of the school that you picked. So basically an enchantment. Which is nice. And that's for every spell level. So you can cast an extra first, an extra second, etc., etc. You're also, this is super useful to you. You gain a bonus on saving throws against enchantments. Because you're an elf, you're already good at that. The other part's nice, though, because it means that other characters that are saving against spells of your school, so enchantment spells you cast, receive a -1 to their save. So your enchantments are harder to resist. So whenever a specialist reaches a new spell level, he automatically gains 1 spell of his school to add to his spell books. The spell can be selected by the DM, or he can allow the player to pick. No role for learning the spell is needed. So I'm guessing you guys just get a new spell. So you guys have one. Or in Leo's case, probably two. That does not seem right, though. Theo, have you seen anything?
No. I didn't really understand how spells known work.
Well, for priests, it's just all, but wizards do still have spell books, so they have a certain number of spells that they're allowed. Maybe, yeah, you just start with one. I mean, it makes a certain degree of sense from what it is, but... by the way, one of the downsides, Leo, is that necromancy and evocation spells are either uncastable or very hard to learn. Yeah, no, they're very hard to learn. When a specialist reaches a new spell level. Yeah, so I'm going to say that you get two spells, and I guess, Nora, you get one for your spell book. Woo! At least for now.
So first,
but if you guys find any scrolls, you can scribe them in.
Wow.
And keep in mind, this is only... One of the spells can be anything on this list. The other one has to be an enchantment spell.
And it's just from the first levels, right?
Yep.
What is this? This says cantrips.
Do they have cantrips?
Huh?
Do they have cantrips?
Well, it's a first level spell called cantrip.
Oh, maybe that's where all the cantrips are then.
Whatever manifestation the cantrip takes, it remains in effect only as... I see. It's just prestidigitation and thaumaturgy combined into one thing.
Yep. And you can use it once.
That sounds lame.
I wonder why you'd pick it. Answer, you won't. Pick something else more useful, especially for this group.
Oh, what if I get like a hunting cat?
Then you have that a hunting cat.
That costs 5,000 gold pieces.
I can afford it.
What?
No, he can't. Hunting cat. I mean, it'd be a trained hunting cat.
It'd be a jaguar.
Range is in yards?
You know. Yeah.
Invocation, conjurations, divinations. Am I still on the level one spells? This is what the level one spells.
Oh, no, I think they're all... Yeah, if you're going down the spell list, it does say when you reach the next level.
There is another enchantment.
Charm. By the way, as a note, there is an appendix near the base on page... Yeah, on page 300, I think, is where it starts. Appendix 5, where it literally just does it by the school. And they do have the actual, like, spell level for the thing. So for you in particular, Leo, if you wish, you can go and check out the enchantment and charm, and that will tell you which spells in first level are enchantment spells.
I see.
I found which an enchantment freaking heck is the Bond. Nicest goddamn thing, and why did they get rid of it?
They have an enchantment called Taunt, which makes everyone hate me, which I don't know if that's useful.
For you, I am going to bet it's not so much. Are they friends? That's kind of nice. I wonder the difference between friends and charm is. Is it just charm lasts a while? And friends is like immediate? Let's find out. Oh, they also have find familiar, so you can have a familiar.
I already have a swan.
I know, but it's not familiar.
I can't jump on Theo. I mean, Leo.
What?
I was going to get a war dog, but no, it's too much money. Oh, whatever, you guys are my war dog.
It looks spells like known by level.
Is it listed on table 4?
Four.
Oh, no. Unless So essentially, so I'm looking, it says character can understand the spell and able to cast it. He can enter the spell in his book unless he's already learned the maximum number of spells allowed for that level. And the only thing that I see that's like declaring how many spells you know is that wizard spell progression table, which just at level one says one. So my only conclusion is
you only know one spell. Although the nice thing is that you can always add new ones, so.
Well, this is applying that you can't, that you have a maximum.
Yeah, you have a maximum number of spells per level.
Yeah.
And for Nor, that's, what, Nor's 12 intelligence? Is 7, Leo's is, what, 6, I believe? So, I mean, it's still quite a number.
Oh, I see, okay.
Because it's based on your intelligence, so. Yeah, Nor has 7 first levels, second levels, third levels, etc., etc. It's for every single spell level, so.
I see.
You know, 6 first, 6 second, 6, yeah. It's not your entire spell book is 6 spells. Oh, that would be really sad.
Miss
Short.
What difference between iron rations and standard rations?
Standard rations are most likely crappier, so stuff like hardtack. Iron rations, I would bet, is more like jerky, is my bet.
Are you sure?
I mean, it makes sense to me. The iron rations are more expensive.
Okay, I just want to make sure I don't buy it, and it's like, oh yes, you actually have iron bar.
That is maybe the case. Why the hell would they be called rations, though? Game. Oh, it's miscellaneous.
Maybe dwarves need iron.
Yeah, thinking about it, that probably is exactly what it is. Why the hell would they be called rations then? And right under the freaking other one. Game, you are confusing. Let me look. Let me just see. Is iron rations like an actual thing? Yeah. No, iron ration. Well, that's a field ration. No, they're apparently food. Where did the iron rations come from? Resonate to the term iron rations, but where the heck did it come from? Is it even a thing? Yeah, so it's basically just a soldier's ration.
I'll take your entire stock.
Yep, iron rations in Gary's mind were things like dried jerky, hard tack, and hard cheese. So, yeah, they're rations that'll basically last forever.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they're ship rations, or soldier rations. So they suck to eat, but unless you get them wet, they're never going to go bad. Standard ration, I'm guessing, lasts are like bread and cheese and other like kind of more good to eat things, but they won't last as long.
Oh, sorry, iron ration. You're expensive, but you're not good.
I mean, if you're out on a journey and you need freaking to not have your food go bad, they'll do that.
Look here, Mitchell. I'm not here to, you know.
You guys won't be on a long journey. Yeah.
Either way, I don't think we're going to make it that far.
First encounter, all of you die horribly.
We have some of the fucking goose.
Hey, he has at least 2 spells.
Oh, I bet it's going to be something great.
Well, I have Charm Person, and I don't know what else to take.
Do you want to take anything that's freaking blasty?
Well, but I can cast it once, right?
Yes, one magic missile is better than 0 magic missiles. In fact, one magic missile might kill someone.
Is it?
I don't even know if magic missiles is something that's a first level spell.
It is.
But... yeah, I think I got everything.
How much damage does it do? Let's find out. Because magic missile, I'm guessing, still works the same way as you point at an enemy and it deals damage. Use of the magic missile spell. Dart forth from the enemies, yeah, and unerringly hit the target, so you can't miss, which is great. Oh, wow. This includes enemy creatures in melee. That's good to know. Target must be seen or otherwise detected to be hit. However, so no total. Blah, 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 blah. How much damage does you deal? Strike the commander of the Legion. It deals 1d4 plus 1 damage. How many hit points do you have, Leo?
I have 2.
Could you kill yourself with a magic missile?
Absolutely, and I think I will.
All right. So the answer is yes. Yes, you very much can kill someone with magic missile. Heck, most opponents are going to have as many hit points as Theo. You could kill Theo with a max damage magic missile.
All right, so I'm taking charm purse and a magic missile.
Yeah, magic missile is still good. It's an evocation spell, which means good luck freaking finding it ever again, but at least you have it. Casting time. And it's freaking 1 for casting time? Holy hell, it's fast. Okay, yeah, no, that's a great spell. Holy hell.
I don't see anything like Quiver, or not Quiver, but a Quill, so I don't think I would...
I'm just going to say you guys have one, then. Don't worry about
it. We have a swan.
Yep. You also have a swan, yes. So you can make your own quivers. Or quivers. Quills.
What page of spells?
Spells are on... do you want this list, or do you want the descriptions?
List.
All right. The spell list is on 164. And a lot of the spells you'll already recognize from 5e. Like, a lot of them, holy hell. Yeah, Burning Hands, Charm Person, Shell Touch, Color Spray. Man, there are some really nice spells here for first level. I guess because you only get to cast them once. So if you didn't have them, like, somewhat... Protection from Cantrips? Okay, what the hell is this? I just noticed that. What in the hell is freaking Protection from Cantrips? And why is it a spell? Come on. Oh, wow. Freaking Magic Mouth is only a second level spell. I think it's higher in the later editions. Which I don't know why. Oh, no. You can make something talk. The horror. I must have passed it, because I'm not seeing it. I am in second level, right? Yeah. Protection from Cantrips. Yep. There it is. It is a touch spell. Yep, by casting this spell, the wizard receives immunity to the effects of cantrips cast by other wizards, apprentices, or creatures that can use the cantrip spell. Neat.
Leo and Dr.
That seems so worthless. Leo has 2.
He has magic missile, right?
He has magic missile and charm person, I believe.
So I can just write that down if I wanted to, right?
If you make the check, yeah. It's not a guarantee, but yes, you could possibly add that to your spellbook. What is your intelligence again? 12? So you'd have a 50-50 shot, yeah, for each of them.
And what would the roll be? A 1d20?
No, it's a D percentile. So, you'd either pick top or bottom, and then if you rolled, bottom, it would be 1 through 50, and if you rolled top, it's 51 through 100. I mean, it's better than nothing. You could each start with higher number of spells than you'd otherwise be able to start with.
Oh, that's the best roll, Mitchell.
I know we're not playing yet. So.
I know. I'm also going to be grabbing a magic missile from my.
All right. Let's see. How long does it actually take to scribe a new spell? Does it say? When the spell is learned, it cannot be unlearned. It remains part of the character's repertoire forever. Unless the character cannot choose to forget a spell.
On spell book, I just put the spells memorized.
Yep. Yeah, I would suggest having a different thing for spells memorized and spell books. Yeah, so spell book pages, and then you just do the thing. I think you actually have two spell book pages, because I believe it's a page per spell. At least I'm guessing it works the same as 3.5, where it's Missile, I believe.
Magic Missile.
Yeah.
Yep.
Nice.
By the way, you have both of these memorized, most likely. Yay.
Okay, what do we do now?
I'm grabbing myself in Leo's hands.
What?
Keep in mind, it is a missile. It is magic missile, as in one, not three. Once you level up to third, it'll be two, and then fifth, and three, et cetera, et cetera, until you get to five.
What?
But yeah, it's one missile.
Look,
what?
I have magic missile.
Yeah, this game does not. It looks at you and goes, "Yeah, we're not holding your hand."
No, they fucking threw us in the. They didn't even say, "Okay, you're gonna learn how to swim. You're gonna go in the deep end." No, they fucking. There's a shark in there. Good luck, son.
Yep. Well, D&D is based on wargaming. You have to actually be somewhat tactical. Thankfully, the module we're using is in Dragonlance, and Dragonlance is a little more talky than other modules. Because I could have thrown you guys into something like Return to the Keep on the Borderlands, which is a combat brawl. Which is bad, since you guys aren't very combat capable. You guys are going to have to try and think outside the box to not die every time you find an opponent. Especially if they outnumber you for the beginning.
We got this.
But I mean, once you get a few more spells under your belt, like Fireball or other things that are AoE based, then you could deal with more opponents. Actually, why didn't either of you take like Burning Hands or something like that?
I don't want to get close to the enemy.
I mean, yeah, but the what enemy, if there's more than
will
three?
Will try and get close to you, though.
Yeah.
What is Burning Hands? Because
I mean, if you guys are facing off with more than three people, or two people, then you can't each cast your magic missile. There's more than two people alive now.
What does Burning Hands do?
It's a cone of fire.
Oh, I thought. Okay.
No, it's not like Shocking Grasp. That. Yeah, no, it's.
I'm assuming
it's that. Let me check.
Yeah,
when the caster casts a spell, a jet of searing flame shoots from his fingertips. His hands must be held so to send forth a fan-like sheet of flames. With his thumbs must touch each other and the fingers must be spread. The burning hands. Yeah, 5 foot long horizontal arc of 120 degree in front of the wizard. So. Deals a d3 points of damage, though. A d3 points of damage plus 2. So it's a d basically between 3 and 5 damage.
Yeah, I'll grab
and
that.
It can light, it can light people on fire, which is also bad for them. Because fire freaking sucks.
I thought it was like a shock touch.
No, shock and grasp is something different. You need to actually poke the person. Yeah, it does mean that you basically have to be in the person's face, but I mean, if you're fighting a bunch of goblins, it's better to kill three or four of them rather than one.
That's why I have my sling. It's bullets.
Yep. Yeah, I'm guessing you did buy bullets rather than just rocks.
Well, the thing is, you don't buy rocks. You just pick them off the ground.
Yep. Exactly. That's why freaking slings are one of the best ranged weapons. Running out of ammo is very hard. Things have to be going very poorly for you. All right. So you guys have spells. So I think we're actually done except for... Oh, they actually have priest spears allowed. Well, that's kind of nice. Did you see that, Theo? For the spells thing?
I did not. Oh, yeah. Sphere-based, yeah.
Yeah. In the there's like a spells thing. So you can
have the character sheet. I did not see that.
So that's neat. Okay. I mean, you can move things over there, or you can just leave it on the character sheet. I don't really care. We both know what you have, so.
I'll later move it over when I get more complex spells.
All right. So your AC is going to be, what is a base AC? For someone unarmored. Yeah, unarmored is 10. Thankfully, your AC surprised and shieldless is exactly the same. You're equally screwed either way. 10, 10, 10. All right. So if you guys have spent all of your money, you've picked spells and gotten all of your stuff. Leo, you are going to have to write down some extra stuff that Nora isn't going to have to because he's not an elf.
Okay.
Oh, you guys are going to have to do height, weight, and whatnot, but that's extra fluffs. Theo, where did you put your special abilities?
What, like for being a gnome?
Yeah.
I just didn't. I was like, I can talk to grand animals, okay. I can see
in the dark, and all the rest of it should be stats and stuff, except for your sense, your stone cunning.
Yeah, and I just kind of was like, if that shows up...
Yeah, Leo, you can either put in your special abilities in attacks or in notes or some such. By the way, you know that you don't have a weapon written down, right?
What? Oh, a dagger.
Yeah, but you don't have it actually like written down. Also, you're not proficient in a dagger, just so you know.
Well, yeah, but that's what I can afford.
Do you want to switch your weapon proficiency over?
No, I'm sticking to longbow, I'm sure.
You just look at your friends. Can you buy me a longbow? Like a quiver full of arrows? So I can actually help you guys.
Oh, fuck off. Awesome.
Yep. It's actually called infravision, by the way, in this game. It's basically the same thing. It's just it is slightly different. Infravision is more like thermal vision rather than like the random magic-y nature of you can see in the dark because of bullshit of dark vision.
28.
So you have a 90% resistance to magic.
35.
I'm gonna real quick make some cocoa, so I'm gonna be right back.
Okay, sounds good. Spells. Well, specifically of sleep and charm. Yep. Remember, you have a +1 to charm-related charm spells resistance too.
+1.
Actually, why didn't you either sleep a first level?
Yeah.
Why didn't you guys just take sleep?
Because I don't know if I should take sleep or charm person.
Sleep is way better than freaking it used to, like it is in 5e. You know how in 5e it's kind of worthless? Because you'll get like two people. Yeah. Sleep in this is significantly more powerful. Okay. At least I'm going to freaking really hope it is, because if it isn't, I'm going to be really disappointed.
All right, then we'll take sleep over charm person.
28.
I mean, you're pretty good at talking anyway, so.
And
so when a cast wizard casts a sleep spell, he causes a comatose slumber to come upon one or more creatures other than undead and certain other creatures specifically excluded from the sleep spell, basically elves. All creatures to be affected by the sleep spell must be within 30 feet of each other. Spell affects 2d4 hit dice of monsters. Which sounds like a lot. And then you actually like go and look at the monsters, and a lot of monsters are very weak. Yeah, 3 kobolds, 2 gnolls, and an ogre. Jeez.
Okay, so what else do we get? There are 5 branches of the elven race?
Yep.
Oh, no.
Technically, in freaking the setting we're using, there's, I think, fewer, but I'm not caring because I can't find any of the actual stuffs. So, okay. Yay. They're all the same for the sake of argument, but it'd just be what you look like.
Okay, +1.
With I'm guessing, except the drow. Don't pick dark elves. Because no one likes you if you're a dark elf.
Okay. So +1 to the bows. I can surprise, if not metal armor. Bonus thingy.
You're a mage. What is armor?
Secret door is not so secret.
Yep. Yeah, when you walk close to secret doors, just like dwarves, you get a ping that basically says, hey, there's a secret door around here.
And I think that's it. Yep.
Secret doors, those constructed so it'd be hard to notice, and concealed doors, those hidden from sight by screens, curtains, and the like, are difficult to hide from elves. Merely passing within 10 feet of a concealed door gives an elven character a 1 in 6 chance to notice it. If actively searching for such doors, elven characters have a 1 in 3 chance, and to find a secret door, 1 in 2. Oh, 1 in 2 to find a secret, a concealed portal. So, goddamn. Yeah, no. Hiding doors from elves and dwarves is hard. So they just walk by and they go, oh. I think dwarves get the same thing. I think they kind of do. As long as it's made out of stone, I think is the main difference. Elves just don't care. They sense it all the time. Dwarves has to be made out of stone.
Okay, so I'm going to have 3 gold and 1.
Yeah, that's nice. You have money. So you can pay for rooms and whatnot. Even though you guys don't need to, because you're going to do something else.
I have a tent right. Also.
None of you are really warriors. Hmm. Hey, Theo, how do you feel about going for knighthood? Because we need one of them's.
Theo?
It's Theo here.
No, he wants to go get Coco.
All right, yeah. Well, how do you guys feel about it? Neither of you are particularly knighty, but mages are close enough, I suppose. Oh, no, actually, sorry. Don't worry about that. I was going to give that to an NPC. Because, trust me, you guys are going to have at least an NPC. So, they'll deal with the knighthood stuff. Give you guys time to do other things. So you don't have to worry about it. You're just the helpers.
Sluts.
All right, I'm gonna go get dinner myself because I have it. It's probably finished now, but you guys should be all set.
Wow.
Oh man. Oh, per month. Okay.
Mm-hmm. We're just set for now.
I mean, you guys should put in the height, weight, age, and handedness stuff, but and what you look like.
Human.
I am human. I am elf. Six, yay. Three.
Do elves mature slower in this thing? Do they mature like fucking 50,000 years?
I'm pretty sure, yeah. They mature slowly. I think at the end of race, they say that sort of stuff. Elves. I have freaking no idea. Feet, I forget everything is in inches and pounds for... Well, pounds is not hard to calculate. It's just pounds, but for inches, they don't bother doing the feet. So at 55 divided by...
Yeah, we... One...
Wow, so elves are really, really short normally. So you are a big, tall elf.
Wait, elves are short?
Yeah.
What? Okay, fine. So 5'5".
Yep. Age. I mean, the average, yeah, the average is like 4 or 5 before the, well, before what the average, so it's they're around 5 feet tall. Base age. Yep. As an elf, you start at age 100. If you wanted to be variable, you're anywhere between 105 to 130.
Do they have a thing for, like, rolling for weight and stuff like
yep.
that?
It's on table 10, 11, and 12 for that stuff. It's on page 33. If you just want the human height and weight, they are, for males, 60 inches. For females, 59. So it's, I think, 5 feet. No. Is that 5 feet, 60 inches? No. Yes, that's exactly what it is, because it's 12 times 12 divided by...
70 for, like, 6.
Yeah.
Yeah.
70, 72 would be 6 feet tall.
Yeah.
So, yep, if you want to roll, it's 2d10. If not, then just pick a height. Most likely it isn't going to matter a hell of a lot, but it's a thing you can do.
I'm going to pick height because I don't want to be a man.
I mean, the shortest you're going to be is 5 roll if you take
D12. Exactly.
Well, roll the minimum is actually 5, 5, 2.
You gotta roll the D12, Nor.
It's two D10s, actually.
For what?
For human average, or for human height modifier.
This is not what I'm rolling for.
Yeah, no, not for elves. Elves are 1d10.
No.
What? No, you, oh, for that? Trick. God damn, no. No.
Don't be a coward, no.
Oh, yeah. How about this? I'm going to do variable age, 15, 1d4.
It'd be 106. That way we're a little, we just got a little.
Okay, so my character is 17.
Yep. Your weight 1.
Yep.
You barely exist at all. You're just a thin waif of a man.
I'm slowly fading out of existence. And so what? So it's going to be 60.
Well, what if you rolled? Well, that's a 74 plus whatever, or not 74 for the thing. It would be 14 on 2d10.
Okay.
Times 29.
I'm going to guess
the weigh 406 pounds.
Say what?
No, that can't be right.
Well, what I'm pretty sure is that you take the base weight, which would be for humans, I guess 140. Because I'm pretty sure the first number is going to be for males, second number is going to be for females. Then add the pound modifier.
Yep.
That's going to be 140 plus 29. That's like 69.
Yeah, that's probably how it is. That's not always how it works, but yeah, that works here. It makes more sense than what they normally do anyway. Yeah.
Well, yeah, I could. Unless it's like, oh, yes, you're actually 29 pounds.
No, it would be added to the base. No, I'm used to 3.5 and 5, where what they do for the weight is you roll your height and then you multiply whatever you rolled for the height dice by what you roll on your weight dice, and then you add that to the base.
This is just a lot more simple, where it gives you like a base, and it's like, okay, then just add the model.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Because I'll travel. All adventurers are assumed to be 16 unless you decide otherwise. Because if you want to be old, you can. It's generally not good, though.
Either way, I was thinking about my character young because, example, very rich.
Mm-hmm.
Not that smart.
Well, that and most likely you'll die after getting too old.
That too.
Yeah. Well, yeah, because you'd be missing 1, 2, 3. Yeah, you'd be missing 3 con. So you'd be at 2 constitution, which is not good as a vulnerable old man.
Just hit me and I explode on them.
You just, someone accidentally bumps you and you just keel over. All right. So, yeah, you guys are all set for mechanical stuff, so it's all just what you look like and whatnot. Oh, by the way, Nora, the currency generator, I know, or conversion calculator is confusing. Why don't they have a copper piece? Oh, they do, I'm just
wrong. Oh, I'm not even looking. I'm not looking at that. I have to say, no, let's not do that.
Leo, do you have any money left at all?
I do. I'm rich. I have
rich for what? A peasant? Seven silver pieces
and a single copper.
Yep.
If I were a rich girl.
Do you think it's pizza okay, hard? You have a goose. You're rich at heart.
Rich at heart.
Thank you. Really appreciate
it. So I have no idea what your guys' backstories is. I just go off what your stat lines look like. Like Theo's, for instance, makes him very much look like a freaking grubby old man who's always wanted to be in the priesthood but couldn't because he's freaking too not wisdom-y enough. Mm-hmm. He's not wise enough. So I got wise. Unfortunately, that took most of his goddamn life. But I don't know. Yeah, the module that we're doing is called Knight's Sword.
Oh, no, so, no. That's our Knight's Sword. We'll do swords.
Yeah, no. That's why you guys are bringing an NPC along. And they're going to be the knighthood person. So, I'll give you guys the main background, you know, when we actually start. But the main thing is... there was a big war, dragon armies came, freaking destroyed a tower that was with bad guys, then smashed in.
All right, we're back.
Killed a guy with a big sword called the Bright Blade. I was actually just giving him a good thing, Theo. So good
right.
So basically you already know the module, Theo. We're doing Knight Sword. So the main thing that you guys are doing is your companions to the NPC who's coming in for knighthood to go through some like trials and whatnot. So you're going to help them with that.
Okay.
So
in a small tent.
Mostly because none of you guys are really knight material. I hate to tell you. So if any of you were, yeah, but you're not. Maybe I'll do Erston. Fucking heck though. He's a beefy boy.
God, I can't fit my wine skin.
Wait, hold on a second. I need to check something. Did I forget something? I feel like I forgot something.
What is Karathos? Is Karathos a knight guy?
Never mind, I didn't forget.
Nah. Actually, I can check. How many spells does wizard have? No, this wizard definitely does not just have one spell. She has five? Two, three, four, five, yeah. Is she really sharp or something? Can't remember what the heck does the I stand for in monster stats. Can't be initiative, that's way too high for a D10. You guys, the wizards might have additional spells.
Or you can beat them.
So, how do you read a spell?
Good. You have a nice amount of money.
Is Pizza Hut open? I don't want to be like ordering shit and they're like not even open.
I mean, what? It's only like 9-ish. It's almost 9 there, right? So,
yeah,
they should still be. I would assume it's not that late.
Yeah, I just don't know. I mean, I don't know if they changed their hours. You know, like to like they're like, oh yeah, we're only working. Like for example, my Macy's is only open from 11:00. XD. Rolling around at the speed of sound.
Man, every single one of these guys actually has a magic item.
And so if one of us plays a thief, we have something to do.
I mean, these are like the pre-generated characters. These are the characters you guys could have gone with.
Oh.
Yeah. So I'm half thinking of just saying, freaking congratulations, you guys get some of this junk. So they're not coming with you. Except for freaking Ariston, who doesn't. He just has plate mail instead.
What are we talking about?
When you say magic item, are we talking like a glowing rock, or are we talking like a plus
sword? One chain mail?
Oh.
Yeah.
Damn.
They're cheating.
I don't know
what. Yeah, sure. Here. You guys can have the rope of climbing, because I don't think any of you can. Can you use the chainmail, Theo?
I think I can. Wearing. Congrats!
You can have that. You can trade out the armor you have,
which is chainmail.
Then yeah, just take back your money. You now have it.
Oh, Jesus, that's like an extra 40 gold pieces. No, it's more, isn't it?
Yeah, chainmail I think is pretty pricey. It's like 50 or 70, something like that.
So how much was that bow again?
Longbow is 75, I believe.
75.
Anything else, Mitchell?
Yeah, I'm looking over their items to see what else I can freaking rip off of them. Ariston? I'm going to guess Ariston Rivengard is the guy that you guys are going to help.
I mean, more for the...
Yeah, I'm saying this is the only guy that I can't take items off of because this is his main thingy.
Well, not yet. Until he dies.
It's very possible. I mean, amongst these guys' items, there's 20 plus 1 arrows. There's a leather armor plus 2 and a short sword of plus 2. The rope of climbing, which I've mentioned, which you guys can have. There's a ring of protection plus 3 that one of you guys can wear. Another set of chainmail plus 1, a battle axe plus 2, and a medallion of faith. Which I don't know what the heck the medallion of faith is. Wonder, is that just in the Dungeon Master's Guide, do you think? Do they have magic items as a list here?
No, the character creation is over. Outside of the items.
Like, other than that, and the mage. Why the hell does she have five mages? You know what? I'm going to say you guys have 5 spells, because that's what she has, and she's a level 1 wizard. So, except for Leo, I guess Leo will give an extra. So you guys can go ahead and pick additional spells. I don't know why the hell it doesn't have anywhere. I mean, that makes sense. That's going with all the other additions. Normally, wizards get 4 or 6. So, yeah, you guys can have 5 spells. Leo can have 6 because of his specialization. Yay.
Hey, Leo.
Hey, time to take magic missile 4 times.
No, you can't take magic missile 4 times. I mean, if you are able to cast more than one spell, you could prepare it 4 times. But remember, these are spells in your spell book. They're not the spells that you have memorized. And they don't even have the actual... Oh, no, they do have the actual equipment. Neat. All right. Sorry, I'm checking for magic item to see if they have magic items in the Dungeon Master's Guide. If I can just throw some more at you guys, so you at least each have one. I guess technically you each have one if I just count the rope, but I'm not going to. Especially because you guys are all level 1, and not all of these pre-gens are. Like, they actually have a couple level 2s and a level 3 in there too.
Where are my spells?
If you look in...
I mean, in the actual book. I don't know where the spells are. I forgot.
If you need the list, it's, I believe, on page... The list is on 164. The actual, explanations are on 170. Or they start on 170.
160.
Yep. Or 169. Yeah.
Because I saw the...
Oh, no, that's educating... Well, yeah, I guess technically there's no spells there, but... Yeah, well, Appendix 2 starts on 168. Yeah, Appendix 3 does start on 170. So...
So what's the... Plus 1 just means my AC is 5 instead of 6, right?
Yes, because it goes down by 1. The Ring of Protection, I think, does the exact same thing for them. So, whichever one of you wants that.
What did you say?
Leo, do you have sleep?
Does he have sleep? I think so, yeah.
Or something.
I think he might have gone to check on pizza.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, let me get like a shield.
Maintaining balance. 160. Oh my gosh, they have a balance. They have a freaking note on balance in freaking this game for magic items. Holy heck. Sorry, I'm saying that like it's crazy, but it's because none of the other goddamn games mention it at all. They're just like, yeah, whatever, just give magic items willy-nilly, it's fine.
Yeah.
Counters. Wow, encounters are after magic items. That's interesting. Where do they not just have lists of magic items? Scrolls. Oh, that's why you don't have... Yeah. Oh, nice. Depending on what paper you actually write a scroll on is whether or not it's actually good enough. That's interesting.
Weird.
Oh, the ink is the final consideration. In this area, the DM has the greatest leeway to demand the most exotic ingredients and processes. So, yeah.
So if your DM wants to be an ass, he can.
Yeah. Well, it's suggested is literally what it says. It's like, hey, if you want to make a scroll of acid splash, you got to go find something to breeze acid.
Hey, Mitchell?
Use the bloods.
What familiars can I get?
I think animals, right? They're just dumber than they normally are. They're smarter than they normally are.
Either way, I have it.
Keep in mind, you have to actually cast it, though.
Oh, I have find familiar.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Which I'm always nice and say, yeah, you've cast it beforehand because freaking hell, of course.
Casting time is a TD.
Power of this conjuration. When the wizard decides to find a familiar, he must load. You need to spend 1,000 gold. What the hell?
Okay, never mind.
Yeah, I'm going to say, for the purposes of if you're taking the find familiar spell, go and take it. You can have a familiar to start. I'm not forcing you to spend 1,000 gold. Holy gods. By the way, yeah, actually, you get a, it's a d20 roll. What did you roll?
Oh, okay, so d20.
Yeah, it's not something that you pick. It's a, you got a roll for it.
Well, it is the casting time.
Oh.
I got a 9.
Yeah, it doesn't matter for casting time. You have a hawk.
Oh, cool.
It's a hawk. It's a smart hawk.
I have a cooler bird.
Come on.
Fuck, Leo.
What?
I have a hawk.
By the way, Leo, go ahead and pick 4 more spells.
What?
I was looking through the NPCs, or not NPCs, the pre-gen characters for the module, and the mage starts with 5 spells. So,
oh, shit.
Okay. Yeah, so go ahead and pick 4 more.
Leo, do you want a longbow?
Yes, I would love one.
Okay.
Yep. We also figured out that all of these freaking NPCs, minus the guy that you're following, has magic items. So I'm freaking saying you guys have magic items too. Yay!
Yeah, I want a bow. I want a longbow.
Enjoy your longbow.
Oh, yep. Hex yeah. Wait, how many arrows do I have?
Zero.
You're gonna have to buy unless those on buys, your own. I spent 75 of my gold. I no longer have anything.
Okay, how much is an arrow? Well, we can look this up.
Yep. I believe it's like a gold for 20 or something like that.
No, shut the fuck up. Don't say that.
They're pricey.
No, they're not. Shut the fuck up. don't say that. Don't curse me like that. Where's the weapons? Oh, there's weapons.
Yeah.
It's not under arrow. It's an under flight arrow or chef arrow.
Yep. Yeah. Which I'm guessing is just different damage types or something.
It's either a D6 or a D8 of damage.
Literally for both of them.
You either do a D6 or a D8. Flight arrow is the cheaper ones.
Yeah. So you deal either a D6 or a D8. Yeah. No, the chief arrows are better.
But I lose out on 6 arrows.
Yeah.
But I'll probably be dead by the time I shoot all of them.
I mean, you can pick them up.
Okay, with my 7 silver, so we'll use 6 of my 7 silver, and that gives me 12 arrows.
Yep. 12. So you can fire your bow 12 times. Yeah, so arrows for longbows are divided into lightweight flight arrows and heavier sheaf arrows. Flight arrows are longer range. Sheaf arrows have a stronger metal head but a reduced range.
How reduced? Like,
if I can... I think like, have it.
It's from 120 to 60.
So you're a longbow, right? So the you lose 20... 20 yards, I believe. Yeah. Well, 20 yards in short range, 40 yards in medium, and a whopping... Actually, it's exactly the same. 40 yards for medium and long.
Wow. Incredible.
You can also fire two shot.
Because we're going to take turn person.
I believe that's how rate of fire works. How many shots that weapon can fire off in one round? Yep.
All right, now we've got
a... Yeah, so you can fire a longbow twice a round. Same for shortbow, too.
What about the sling?
Let's find out. How many times can you fling? The sling is one. It makes sense. Oh, though with the staff sling, you can do two.
Aha!
I'm guessing it's one per... I'm guessing, anyway. I mean, that makes sense, right? The first number is how many shots you can make, and the second number is how many rounds it takes to fire them. Makes sense to me, anyway. So yeah, crossbows are once a round. Heavy crossbows are once every two. Because you have to reload it. You can throw three daggers in a turn. Or sorry, two daggers and three darts, actually. I have a feeling this is how they get around the you're going to be facing tons and tons of monsters. Because you're almost always going to be outnumbered, unless you bring friends. Or it's something big and scary.
Alas, we did not bring friends.
Nope. Well, you brought a friend. Kind of. I'm going to guess they don't have a list of magic items beyond the things. The Book of Artifacts is going to literally just be artifacts. I don't need those. I need, like, a list of magical weapons and whatnot.
And we're going to put a wizard's
spell. I mean, do I just want to give you guys... Nah, because then...
And then we also...
I guess I could give you guys, like, magic arrows. Yeah, actually, there are magic arrows. Hey, Leo, take 20 magic arrows.
Heck yeah.
They're only plus one magic arrows, but they're magic arrows. Congratulations. And Nor, do you want to have 20 magic sling bolts?
Sure.
Neat. Trust me, magic items aren't the massive game changer that they are in other games. They make them slightly better, and that's all, until they get up to artifact stuff.
I hope this gets to the point where I can just start melting gold pieces and having silver.
Freaking whipping melted gold pieces at people. Oh, they do have magic item tables. Freaking goddamn it. Of course, I find it the moment I give up on it. 183. It's in an appendix. That's why I wasn't seeing it. Protection from werebores. Holy, this is a mess. It's just table after table. Okay. I mean, I guess I could have given you guys a scroll or something, too. Yeah, okay. So, in addition to whatever you guys have already gotten, I'll take away the rope of climbing. You guys don't need that. I'll give you guys each a potion of healing, too. Because I have a weird feeling you guys might need it.
How much do they heal? Is it just the 1d8 plus 1?
I'm guessing. Let me see if I can't find potions of healing. You know what? They probably just work exactly as the potion of healing of etc. So, yeah, I'm guessing it works just like the spell.
Okay.
So, potion of healing plus 1. Yay.
I guess we could take find familiar.
Oh, potions and oils. Okay, here we are. Do they not just have, like... There's extra healing. Oh, boy. Yeah. Find familiar, by the way, normally has 1,000 gold piece freaking upfront cost. I'm waiving that if you're freaking filling your spell book with that spell. But if it dies, you're going to have to pay the cost.
First 10 minutes, I'm going to shoot some of my hawk.
You're going to... Don't send your hawk into combat with monsters. The monsters will hit it and murder it. At least they'll try. Most likely they won't be very good at it. Do they not have, like, a basic potion? Potion. Oh, these are all freaking... Yeah. Kind of love how they have just DM's choice for all of these tables. Like, why the hell would you not be rolling on it? Or, you know, maybe that's not the point. Maybe it's just kind of, you're supposed to roll random loot and then you can say, cursed items, yay! Oh, look at that, they have a bag of devouring right on the list. It's not even a natural one.
Just in case I need to taunt somebody.
What if we put someone in the bag?
I'm guessing they're devoured.
Oh, see, that's a great assassin technique.
Yeah. If I remember correctly, a bag of devouring, because they put it in 5e, is a cursed bag of holding. So when you put things in it, sometimes they don't come back out. And sometimes when you put your hand in it, sometimes your hand doesn't come back out. I like how they have getting lost. Then they have the chances. And then it has just lost as the first one, and then hopelessly lost.
Oh, no.
And then the dealing with lost characters. So you might find your way out, and then the, nah, you're freaking entirely boned. Yeah, I'm guessing potions of healing are just they're normal potions. So they're literally just the spell. Oh, they have military occupations. That's kind of nice. Oh, I think all these are the NPCs. Yeah, NPC professions. Holy gods, there's so many. Yep, apothecary, architect, armorer, aerosmith, assassin, astrologer, baker, barber. I think some of them don't actually have some of these just don't have it because they're obvious. Like baker, architect, armorer, it's obvious what they do. And then there's barber, otherwise known as a surgeon, bloodletter, dentist, and haircutter. This is all one job. He can cut your hair, he can rip teeth out, and he can do surgery on you. Beggar. Oh, barrister, yeah. Spurrier. Holy heck, this is actually kind of nice. Because I would have never... I might have to keep this list for other, like, more further along D&Ds. This is actually kind of useful. I can't really use it as a roll chart, but at least it's something to throw a thing my way. Oh, yeah, and hirelings. Oh, they have actually, like... Oh, right, yeah. By the way, NPCs have morale in this edition of D&D, meaning they'll roll, and sometimes if they're freaking... if the battle's going poorly, they'll run away. Because freaking you don't want to die.
Hell yeah.
Because dying is bad. So they actually have kind of a similar thing to... what is it for Warhammer? Warhammer's morale system, where enemies like will run away. I think it actually works exactly the same. You roll 2d10 or 2d6, and if you beat, I think if you roll under the number, you're good. No, if you beat the number, you're good because you wanna. No, if you roll under the number, because a 12 is there's certain monsters with like 12, so they never run away because they're undead or constructs or whatever, so they don't. You can't really be afraid if you're dead already.
Yeah.
I can't find magic items. I have lists, but I don't have actually what they do.
Huh. Okay, well...
are they in this, maybe?
Unless there's anything else, I think I want to take a...
Yeah, I think we're all set, except for if you guys want to do any description you wish to do, then that's on your prerogative. Otherwise, you'll be a human or a elf and a gnome. Congratulations with whatever name you put.
I'll actually add to that later, being like, my name is Nor.
Yep, but otherwise, yeah, we're all set. Also, Nor, did you get my message about the godbound stuff?
No. I just saw the, hey, we're starting soon, and then I woke up. Well, I had an alarm. I saw it, like, hey, something. Yep.
How does your arm appear for Drake? That was the question. Because I've added a new thing in the Godbound thing that you can look at.
Where is that?
In Heroes Risen? It was only like a few minutes. Well, not a few minutes ago. 4 hours ago now, but it's between. Are you fine with having it in RPGs or fun? That nor are you awake? Did the messages get eaten? Discord, why? As I was saying to Theo, I think I said it while you were here. But the description and the past careers and relationships and whatnot, I'm going to leave for you guys to do. Honestly, I should actually have you guys add some other facts too before we start.
And where was it? In Hero D&D?
No, I literally, it's a DM to you.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Oh, how does the arm appear on Drake?
Yes. Okay. Yep. I'm trying to remember, what armor do you have, Drake?
I had a breastplate.
Breastplate, which I believe is medium.
Yes, it is.
Yep. Hey, what save do you want to be bad at?
Huh?
What save do you want to be bad at?
None.
That's not an option.
Oh, come on. I can't do like that. Oh, yeah, that's one thing I forgot.
No, remember for Godbound, if you wear armor other than light, you take minuses. So, hardiness, evasion, or spirit. You want your armor to suck at being freaking resistant to acid and whatnot, suck at making it harder to dodge things, or suck at freaking magical defense. That's not the best thing you're good at, but right now is evasion.
I don't know, probably magical defense.
Alright.
I need to remember my thing of what I'm actually going to be doing in Godbound. Well, not like, I know what I'm going to be doing, I mean, just like,
I mean, to be fair, you guys, I think, have multiple of you have a, Drake, I know you don't, but other ones do have the divine gift part, so. I'm trying to remember how you apply a penalty to the saving throw based on armor. Oh, it's right here. Spirit. Nice. Alright, Theo, by the way, it's the same question, because you also have armor.
I will...
I mean, you can select it when you come in, but...
Yeah.
Rally actually has heavy armor, doesn't he? Yeah, because he is full plate, doesn't he?
I forgot. Is that the artificer thing? Where, you know, you can make armor, but remove one thing for...
Yep.
Was that a greater gift or a minor gift?
That was... I believe a greater gift, because that makes them inherent. Like, when you make armor, it's just inherently magical, I think. Also, Leo, we're all set if you're still here.
Yes.
All right. Yep, we're all done for that stuff. Perpetual for perfection. Yeah. You gain a +1 to hit for weapons. I believe you make magical weapon. Yeah. Weapons and armor you create count as magical items. And magical armor automatically has that as a stat.
Is there greater or lesser?
That's a greater.
Oh, damn it. Yep. Oh, whatever. Either way, I wasn't... I'm not planning on using armor forever. I had plans on... I
mean, you guys can immediately take it off the moment you get in. So,
well, that's the thing. Like I've been trying to say is that
I'm setting you guys up with what you currently have is the main thing. Yeah, I'm almost certain Nor Rally has plate. So heavy plate. What would Norix want to have save penalties on? I'd probably bet on not his evasion or spirit because he's the best at hardiness. I don't know. We'll put in evasion and spirit just for the sake of it, but he can change that if he so wishes. I'm not going to hold him to that. And Z definitely has light, so I don't have to bother asking.
How do I even... should I check the shield thing?
Yes, because you do have a shield.
Okay. And how do
Raliano doesn't. You have one.
How do I... Oh, I see where I apply it.
For the save penalties?
Yeah.
Yeah, you just click one of the three buttons in the bottom of the armor section.
Yeah.
Mitchell, did I talk to you about my sniper?
Yeah.
Did you did. Did I give you a list of what I was going to get?
You did. I have no idea where that went, though, because I don't believe I wrote it down.
I can just look it up.
Let's see. Just realized... I'm hoping you used cyber.
Okay. Figured out my last...
Yeah, okay. There's your figured out the last...
Are we clear to start, though?
Godband?
No.
Yeah, we're all set.
All right.
We're not starting tonight because we'd be starting at 10. Oh. Sorry, no.
I don't know why. I thought we were starting tonight. My apologies.
No, this was a... We're making characters because I was pretty sure it was going to take a bit. And two hours was a bit. So... Yeah, no, I still need to read through the module and whatnot, so okay. You guys are going to have to give me until, like, next week. Maybe we'll do, like, next Thursday or something like that.
Yes.
Stop giving Leo an excuse to stop running his stuff.
You whore. Remember, I'm the temporary DM.
Poor Leo.
Were you temporarily? I haven't heard that.
Have you not heard that story?
No.
Okay, so once upon a time, and you were in that campaign. Do you remember Stormy's first campaign?
The one I was in for like 2 seconds. Yes, I remember that one.
You were like an orc wizard or some shit. No, a deep gnome wizard.
No. Yeah.
Deep gnome wizard.
I died in the first session because I rolled like a 9 and then a nat 1 on my death saves in the first goddamn combat. Yes, I remember that well. Okay. And then I got brought back by a talking owlbear. That was. Frankly, the kind of thing that kicked me over the rest of it. But regardless,
so that, as you remember, Stormy did not run if she did not have everybody there.
Hmm.
I don't know if you remember that, but she did. She would not run if she didn't have everybody there.
No, I didn't hear that.
or she needed like everybody but one, like only one person could be absent. I think
so. One person was missing. Oh God.
It was over. Yeah. So. So she was then, so we paused that for a while, and then she was like, she did a reboot, and we were trying again, and then she was like, okay, well, let me just write, I'm gonna take a small break, but I'm gonna write some more, and she was like, starting to run some sessions, she ran like, I think 2 sessions, so I was like, DMing looks interesting, I'll run a session, so like, whenever, I was like, okay, whenever you're not running something, I'll run it. I'll run my little like temporary thing, like my.
And then you got ended up being the main DM for a while, for the rest of it.
And she's like, okay, that sounds good. And I was like, yeah, okay. And then behold, then that's when my fucking seven deadly sins campaign came about. That shit rolled through, and that was that. And then Stormy stopped. Like we never, like no one ever said like. Oh, are you, is your campaign coming along? I would sometimes ask, I'd be like, how's your campaign? She's like, oh, I'm still thinking, and I'm like writing stuff. And I'm like, okay.
Yep. And that's what I'm doing right now, is poking Stormy every Sunday and being like, hey, are we going to play? Or
So then she ended up canceling it. And then she was like, she said, I think it was either between Pangea or after Pangea. She said she was going to run out a campaign. And well, that was our fault, where she wanted us to be like heroes and stuff. And none of us were good. We were all either evil or neutral. I think the closest we had was Dylan, who was lawful neutral. That was the best we had. So she got mad, and so she, that campaign boomed. So we're not sure why, what happened with the Humblewood, because she was super excited. She talked about it for months. Like, the second the book gets here, we're going to play. And we all enjoyed it. I mean, we were all being goofy little critters.
Yeah.
I thought we were playing as it was foretold. No one was, like, killing nobody. Mm-hmm. So I don't know what happened. Nope. But yeah, so, and that's my favorite joke, is just, like, remember, I'm just the temporary DM.
Yep.
I've run so many campaigns, shit campaigns, and here I am, temporary DM. Temporary DM, Mitchells, and don't you forget it.
Yep. So rather than being a forever DM, you're a temporary DM?
Yeah, I'm the temporary DM. Don't you forget
it. If you flip your name tag around, it's forever DM.
You're here forever. No.
Been cursed. Yep.
As much as I've had to deal with that for a long time, like, more recently I've had people who are interested. So I'm like, hey, you're interested in DMing, can I play? Just leap
I
on.
No, the second somebody says, when Jake was like, I'm going to DM, he's going to DM, I'm like, ugh, it's fine.
Jake's done a good job so far.
He's doing fantastic, I love it.
Yeah. Although, to be fair, he's gotten a lot of chances to watch good DMs too.
Yeah.
And bad DMs. We've had a lot of a good mix, so he has the... He has some background now.
Our mistakes.
Learn from the bad and the good.
What gauntlet to see how much he's learned? Fucking 12 people? Oh my god.
Yeah. I mean, it's going well so far.
Yeah,
because I know I can't do 12 people. My max is 8, and that starts to get to me. I prefer 4 to 6. That's where I'm most comfortable. Because I run groups that are 12, and they just... It might be easier online, to be honest. But, because I've ran those in real life, and oh my god, it's trying to get 12 people to freaking stop doing other things and focus on what you're trying to do is a freaking nightmare. So, maybe it'd be a little easier here, especially because I can, you know, pull all the character sheets up and look at them, but goddamn.
Okay, now I think I'm going to finally jump off, but I think, Mitchell, I remember what I was going to do. I think I was going to grab Warding, which is okay. 4 AC.
Oh, could I have...
When you can make the thing, yay. Or get attached. What were you saying, Theo?
Could I have the Godbound book? Because apparently I don't...
Do you not have it? I think I actually have it as a drive thing. I'll see if I can't pull it up.
I'm pretty sure when I get the chance, I'm also going to peel my skin off.
Not good bound. I don't have it. Really? That is somewhat surprising. Yeah. I mean, I